Want to help me troubleshoot a TLS Handshake problem? Let's go ahead and get to it. But before we get into the packets, let me tell you a little bit about the problem. We had an issue where some clients were able to successfully connect to a secure web server and some were not. So let's go ahead and take a look at the packets to really find out what was going on. All right, so here this is just a standard thread, standard TCP conversation. Here I can see I've got the syn/act. There's my handshake. I'm establishing a connection to port 443. And right after that, as TLS does, is it then goes and establishes its handshake. That's usually where we see a client hello go to the server with a few different options, and then the server hello comes back, continuing that handshake process. So here we've got our client hello, and I can see that the client hello gets there. The server comes back and says, great, thumbs up, I got your packet. That's what this ACK is. Okay, I click that ACK. I can see my check mark over here. Right after that, the server comes back and it does a TCP window update. Now I might be thinking, oh no, this is a TCP problem. We got a window update. Hang on a second. Let's just investigate this for a quick moment. If I come and open this up in TCP, here I can see that my window size, let's just check that out. Here this says my window size is 12, but wait, that's not the true window. The actual calculated window size is 6144. If I look at the packet previous, 7680. So this just tells me that there's a few bytes sitting in that buffer, in that TCP receive buffer, but I still have some room to work with, 6144. So that's why my eye is going to jump right over that. I'm not going to worry too much about the window update. I might look at that later. However, boom, fatal. That looks a lot worse, doesn't it? Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at what this is talking about. All right, let me open this up. And I know I see some stuff up here in the info area of Wireshark, but let's actually look deeper into the protocol. Okay, so record layer, fatal, the description was protocol version. So the server's coming back and saying, nope, I'm not talking to you because of the protocol version. Okay, there's our clue. Let's go back to the client hello. What on earth are we doing? Okay, so client hello. Now, one thing during the TLS handshake that a client does is it's going to offer to the server the different TLS versions that it's able to support. Okay, so SSL 3.0, TLS 1.0, TLS 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. But here, if I see here, the client is saying, okay, version TLS 1.0, all right, so that's an older version. If I come down here into the client hello, I see that version again, TLS 1.0. So I can see that I'm using TLS 1.0, 1.0 version in that client hello, and I don't have any other extensions where I'm advertising any other supported versions. So that's a pretty common thing that you'll see these days. In the client hello, you'll see it use one version like 1.0 or 1.1, but really it's saying, hey server, just so you know, I'm using these lower versions just in case something stops me in the middle, like a firewall that doesn't yet support TLS 1.3. But just so you know, I can also support TLS 1.2 and 1.3. Okay, so in that client hello, we just don't see the versions offered in an extension. So this TLS 1.0 here and here is real. That's what the client is able to do. So that's why the server comes back and says, we're not playing those games. Look, I'm not playing some old version of TLS that is known broken. If you're not in the now using TLS 1.2 or 1.3, we're not going to talk. Right after that, server says, thanks, been a nice day. Let's fin ack, we're done. And we've torn down the connection. So this was just a quick look at what happens if the client is not able to support a modern version of TLS. Here, the server shut it down. So in this case, that's exactly what we found. Some clients were using an older version of TLS that needed to be updated, and then those clients were able to start working. So I hope that this helped you learn a little bit more about the TLS handshake. More to come, absolutely. Thanks for stopping by.